Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play TMNT 3 Secret of Manhattan. Yeah, sorry for the abrupt ending of the last video. I really tried to squeeze in too much into one video, and I barely fit it into that 15-minute window, so this time I'm going to try to do less in one video. Maybe I'll only do two stages. Last time was a little longer because the intro. Last time we ended on the end of scene 2. I left it right here. This was the amount of points I got, so let's go on to scene 3 before we waste too much more time. Yep. The Bridge of Danger. The Danger Bridge. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is the actual Golden State Bridge, but this definitely is the Golden State Bridge. If it's not, it's designed exactly the same to look like it. And this was the stage when I was a kid I always dreaded. It was like, if I could get to this stage, I have gotten as far as I'll ever get. And it was like, if I ever get past the stage, I'd be all proud of myself. I used to really suck at this game as a kid. Like, I wouldn't get it. I wouldn't know any of the patterns. I wouldn't know nothing. And by the time I get to the boss, who I'll talk about when I get to him, yeah, he used to kick my ass, but I'll talk about him later. Alright, I'm just kind of dodging these guys, as I was going to say before. The only way to really hurt these guys, like, quickly without getting your ass handed to you, is to just use your special attack. I know it drains one thing, but if you can hit two for one, you're saving a hit. Because these guys, once you hit them, they just kind of shoulder tackle you right across the screen. It's a bitch. And then look out in this part. Here comes, there he is, the final boss of the level, but he's not going to show his face to us now. You can recognize him, his face. You know who that is. We'll talk about him when we get to him. Damn it. Man, I usually never get hit by those grenades, but my dodging skills have gone out the window since I started doing this LP. My god. Okay. And there's these pink Power Rangers with spears. Purple Power Rangers. How did I resist not calling them Power Rangers in the last video? Even though I know they're the Foot Clan, it's just, there's every color of the fucking rainbow here, so you can just call them Rangers. Pink Ranger. We just saw the Purple Ranger a second ago. Let's see what next Ranger we'll see. Oh, look, it's the Dark Blue Ranger. I don't know. Navy Ranger? Navy Blue Ranger? I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about anymore. Yeah, and there's more of these muscle heads that are best taken care of with the special attack. Raph's special drill attack. Okay, oh look, it's the White Ranger, watch out for Tommy! Ki-Eye! Oh my god, I don't think I'm gonna make it to the mid-level boss here without getting killed. I already only have 3 hits left. I said most levels have multiple parts. This is all one level, but it just has a mini-boss halfway through, and here he is. Mr. Slash. No, not the Slash from Guns N' Roses, but the Slash who... Oh, I paused that for a second. The Slash who is commonly referred to as the Fifth Turtle. Oh my god, he's really easy, and I'm only gonna spam this because I know... Oh, okay, got him. Right after this, right over here to the right, there's a free pizza that'll fill up your life completely. First one you see in the game. There are a few in the game. Try to, if you can plan it out right, you can get them at the right time. I didn't plan very good, I died right before that fight. There's the Red Ranger, look at the rarely seen Orange Ranger. I guess it could be the Yellow Ranger. Yeah, I didn't expect to babble on about Power Rangers in the Turtles video, but here I am, out of creative things to say, and so I am calling Turtles things Power Rangers. Yeah, shh, creative guy that I am. Gonna look out up here. Here comes these guys on boulders. Just drop kick their ass right off. Here comes a couple more. Don't let them run your ass over. And moving along. Okay, we're almost to the boss. Actually, the boss is right up here, but we gotta go through a few more sets of enemies. Ah, shit, missed. I'm always trying to figure out what the hell they swing at you. When I was younger, I thought it was like a, you know, steel pipe or something. But if you look at it closely, it looks like one of those metal beams used to like build buildings. Oh look, it's the Powder Blue Ranger with throwing anvils at me. How cute. Okay, now I have to talk about this boss for just a second. I've recently discovered how easy this boss really is. He just takes a long fucking time to kill if you do it this way. He actually is really easy. When he goes to swing back that ball on his head, you just jump and kick him, and if you can get another hit, that's good. But if you do this strategy, it takes a really long time to get him. and I wouldn't recommend it for anybody trying to be in a hurry. Best way to really do it is just use spam your special move, but I'm not gonna do that right now. Oh, and by the way, I didn't even say his name when he popped out. He popped out so quickly, I just kinda got into it. This is Bebop, for those who don't know, and can't tell and know the characters. The only difference, really, is he's got that ball on his head. That's not a common thing for him to have. Oh, that was my fault. I jumped too early. But yeah, this is a pretty easy strategy to get in. You just gotta get move quick, because he'll kick you. See, now I'm losing my rhythm here. Ah, shit. Okay. Here we go. Get back into it. Ah, come on. There we go. Got him flashing. That means he's almost done. Let's be careful. Come on. Ah, you warthog. Gee, Shredder. I thought we had the turtles this time. Oh, yeah, that was my terrible impression of Bebop from the turtle show. Wow, that was really bad now that I think about it. That was like a mixture of the Rocksteady and Bebop accent all in the same thing. Wow. That was bad. Let's just throw this in there. He's gotta be- Oh! Oh my god. See what I get? Look at that, watch. I bet she's like, yep, two hits away. What a waste of a life. And I'm not talking about my life. I just meant this turtle's life. Alright, see, here you go. The blimp. They should have a level where you could actually fly in the blimp. That would have been really cool. Or even drive in the car. You don't get to drive in the car in this game either. In fact, the only Turtles game I know of that you drive in the car is the very first one. There's actually levels where you go around on a world map in the car. And now I'm wasting too much time talking. Let's go to scene 4. Hurry. We're gonna run out of time. Nah, we're doing good on time right now. We should have plenty of time to finish this level, even though there's two parts to it. There's not a halfway boss, so we should be fine. Oh, unless we start off badly like that. Okay, flip these little bastards. But yeah, I was talking about earlier how the bridge level, that would be like where I thought I was at the end of the game. Or not the end of the game, but I felt like I was really far. But god, I did not know that this game had so much to it when I was a little kid. Once I learned the code and found out how many levels there were, oh my god, I was so amazed at how much more game that I was missing, and I just sucked. So I used to abuse that code and just say I beat the game, because I'd use the code and beat the game. Since then, I've been able to beat this game legitimately. It's just that code made this game a lot more fun as a little kid than it probably would have been. I mean, I used to get sick of it because I'd get stuck. And when I get to this level, I'd be like, dang, this has got to be close to the end. It's so hard to get this far without dying so much. But if you got enough skills, you know, dodging and knowing the patterns of these enemies and killing them faster than they can hit you, it's not really that hard. I mean, I wish I had the patience as a kid to just sit around and kick ass at this game and be like, yeah, I whooped the shit out of that game, getting to the end without even dying. But, I digress. So, as a kid, I think the furthest I got after using all my continues and not using any of the extra life code, I think I got to the end of this level and into the next level after this. And I think that's the sewer level, to say it. And I think that's as far as I ever got. It really was. Without the code. I'm talking without the code. But yeah, I'm kind of thinking about later in the game right now, dreading some of the bosses later. They're not easy. They're very irritating, especially if you try to use the pattern to kill them. Almost better to just spam your attack and let yourself get hit just so you can deal some damage on them. Okay, and I remember I was talking about the details in the last video, but this level is a perfect example of detail. I mean, look at all the different places that the foot soldiers come out from. I mean, earlier you saw them jumping over the wall. They came out the windows, they came out of the alley, they jump out of the sewers, they jump out these windows right here, and the windows stay it shows the animation of them crashing through the window, and it actually stays broken, so you see the effects of them showing up. And here you go, they drop from the wall. I mean, the attention to detail in this game is freaking amazing. Oh my god, and I cannot time that, why? I used to love hitting that freaking sewer thing right back in their face, and now I can't even do it. And see, and they pop out of the sewers. More Pink Rangers. Little bastard. They throw spears. Spear chuckers. Ooh, that. My bad on that. That was a racist remark. I'm sorry. But he was really a spear chucker. He had a spear and he was throwing it. Sorry. Yeah, see, and here's more creative ways for them to show up. There's statues that come to life. Yeah. And then there's, like, here's this part where they slide down the pole, like, they look kind of like a spider crawling down a wall, but they're actually just sliding down the pole. Here she comes, slide down the pole. Here she goes, slide down the pole. There she is. There she go. There she is. There she go. There she goes, slide down the pole. Oh, sorry, wow. I can't believe I started singing E40. Yeah, that was E40 if you couldn't tell. Let's see if we can time this one better. Got him. Yeah. Ooh, it's the Indiana Jones Ranger. He's got a whip. I couldn't help it. Oh, and these guys, they do a flying karate chop. Ah, damn it. Fuck it. Ah, you karate chop guys. They do like a flying stage dive karate chop. I don't know how you describe that move. Oh my god. Whew, almost got dropkicked there. Oh, come on. I'm dying at the most sad parts, just right in the middle of fighting foot soldiers. I had my dodging skills going, where I was just... Man, I can't describe how crappy I'm playing right now. And Indiana Jones Ranger returns. I wasn't ready to hit that back at him, I just didn't want him to throw it at me. And here comes some barrel guys. I don't know what color ranger he is. What color would you call that? Greenish blue, bluish green, I don't know, some kind of blue. Jump over these barrels real quick. And I always thought this was like a hard thing to dodge. You could just stand in the middle and jump. It's really easy. Again, more detail in the level. You see these cars in the background. They're not just for decoration. They really aren't. I was gonna time that better, but they didn't come out yet. Here they come. Here you go. They jump out the door. Look at that. Man, and the door stays open. Kind of the animation and detail, I swear, still amazing me to this day. And I'm talking about animation and detail in an 8-bit game when we had HD graphics, 1080p. Fuck you, muscleheads. You Arnold Schwarzeneggers. Don't even ask where that accent came from. That wasn't even close. I'm not even gonna try to get closer, even though I could. more of these teal rangers who throw knives at you. Wouldn't be so bad if they only threw one knife. They throw one at an angle and one straight at you. God! Where is my skill at? Left it back in 1994 with my 5-year-old self. God, terrible. Okay, finally we got to the halfway point of the stage, and we are running out of time. Okay, this is actually a good place to stop. So, okay, yeah, there's no enemies running at me right here, so we're good. Yeah, the next video is just gonna be start with this short little part of the level, so, instead of going into the abrupt ending like last time, I'm gonna try to plan this out better, so, until the next time, I'll just say peace.